cells ignoring.
Okay, so let's revise it a bit. We said that when the pathogen enters into the tissue and damages the tissue, the dying cell would release the signaling chemicals that would be approaching to the macrophages.
Okay.
While the macrophages would receive the signal, they would be approaching to the infection site, engulfing, at this point, they would be engulfing the pathogen, killing it by the lysosome. This is also asked in the past papers, that yes, how the lysosomes would help the phagocytes. So they would be killed it by the lysosome, and they would present their antigens on their plasma membranes. Now the plasma membrane, these plasma membranes, once with the antigen attached, they would be approached by the T lymphocytes, T helpers from the same tissue, because as I said, the T lymphocytes or the B lymphocytes or the majority of white blood cells, they mostly are present inside the tissues.
Yes, sir.
They are less present in the circulation, and they are mostly present inside the tissue. So once the macrophage would present the antigen, the T helpers would approach to the antigens, and only that T helper would be able to attach to the antigen, which is exact complement to the presented antigen. Now, once it would attach, it means that this one is necessary to increase, because there is more chance that we are going to expose from the same antigen again. So it means that not this one is going to be expanded, not this one is going to be expanded, only the one to which the antigen has been exposed and attached requires to be expanded. So the T lymphocyte would immediately perform the mitosis and increase its number, called as clonal expansion, forming the memory cells. And the benefit of increasing the memory cell, it basically, we are increasing the number of complementary receptors, because it is actually the receptors that is required. Once the receptor is attached to the antigen, now it would immediately induce an immune response. And the second thing after attaching to the antigen would be the release of the cytokines. The cytokines basically are signaling chemicals which are basically going to move towards two different kinds of the cells present in the tissues. One is B lymphocyte and the other is T killers. So we were talking about the B lymphocytes. The B lymphocytes are also very much in number. Just like the T lymphocyte, they are also in millions. And many of them would start, all of those which would receive the cytokine would start approaching towards the site of infection. Once they would approach, remember the B lymphocyte can either go to macrophage or they can go to the T lymphocyte, T helper, because both are presenting the antigen. So it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to which they attach, because attachment to either of them would result in the same response.
Okay.
So the B lymphocyte would attach only one of them, which is complementary. It would attach to the antigen. It would attach to the antigen. And once it would attach, now it would immediately respond. How it would respond? It would release... it would also perform the clonal expansion and create more memory of B lymphocytes. The memory of T lymphocyte is separate and B lymphocyte is separate. So it is again the clonal expansion. I would write CE over here. And it would change itself and create some other cells which are called as the plasma cells. The plasma cells are basically those cells. These are B cells. There is no, like, the name would never change. These are B cells, but now they would produce the antibodies.
Okay.
They would produce the antibodies. So, as I was mentioning a few minutes ago, that the T helper cells would be killed in the HIV. So, if the HIV would kill the T helper cells, they would not be able to invite the B lymphocytes. Once the B lymphocytes are not invited, it means they would not be producing any memory, and they would not, or they would be, if they are producing, there would be a very short number of, there would be a very short number of the memory cells and plasma cells and ultimately antibodies. Yes.
Okay, sir. So plasma cells are actually antibodies.
No. They are not antibodies. They are the cells that would produce the antibodies.
Okay.
Because plasma cells are cells. Antibodies are proteins.
Okay, sir. Yes.
So they would be produced by the plasma cells. All right. So this is a whole set of immune response. And this kind of immune response is called as the primary immune response, where you are very first time you are exposed to this particular antigen, and it takes a long time. That is why you get infected, you get sick, you get a lot of uncomfortable feelings during this whole thing. So that is what the primary immune response looks like. Now, but the blessing is that you are now having the memory. And this memory would help you next time if you are exposed again. See, if you, now suppose, I said in the very beginning that we have millions of white blood cells.
White blood cells.
Lymphocytes especially. Suppose if you start performing the clonal expansion to all of them, number one, it would occupy your whole body. Number two, it's an unnecessary increase of cells. And number three, unnecessary consumption of body energy.
Yes, sir.
So this whole thing, that is the main reason that we basically don't expand all the B or T lymphocytes, but only that B or T lymphocyte would be expanded. That is required, or basically that is complementary to the antigen, about which there is more chance that you are going to exposed. You are going to be exposed. So you can say the acquired immunity is different in different regions. For Africa, it is different. For Asia, it is different. For USA, it is different. For Europe, it is different. Why? Because the type... Can you hear me smoothly?
Yes, sir. Yes, I can hear you.
Okay. The type of antigens to which the humans expose in different regions is different.
Yes, sir.
So that is why acquired immunity in me is different. Even a person from my country, if he's living in USA, it means that person would be would have different acquired immunity because he is now exposing to different antigens.
Okay, sir.
And on the same principle, the vaccination programs are designed. In the infectious diseases, you have learned about this particular topic, vaccination programs. All the vaccination programs are always made on the basis of the prevalence of an antigen. I would not name pathogen here. I would name antigen. The prevalence of the antigen would be designing your vaccination programs. Okay. So now,
sir,
this is the primary. Please, sure.
This was my confusion when I was doing the chapter, infectious diseases. So there was this one question that in Africa there is more problem of anemia due to the anopheles mosquito bites. It was a question like that. It was anopheles mosquito bites ki wajah se wo jo anemia zyada kyun hota hai.
See, this is a question.
Yes,
this is, let me just tell you. Anopheles mosquito is a carrier of malaria.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, there is a disease called as sickle cell anemia.
Yes.
Now, what is the correlation? See, malaria is a disease in which the pathogen of malaria, which is the plasmodium, basically divides inside the red blood cells, inside the healthy red blood cells.
Yes.
And it would be ultimately causing the anemia. And the Plasmodium falciparum, the Plasmodium falciparum is the strain of the Plasmodium that is the deadliest and most abundant in Africa.
Okay, sir.
Now, the Plasmodium requires the healthy red blood cells. If a person is,
No, sir, it's understood.
Complete it. The Plasmodium, the people who have the healthy red blood cells would die because of malaria, because the healthy red blood cells would be a favorite or the most recommended site for Plasmodium attack.
Okay,
If there
sir.
are people with sickle cell anemia, but the sickle cell anemia means only those people having the heterozygous genotype, not the homozygous recessive. The person with the homozygous recessive genotype for sickle cell anemia would die after birth.
Okay,
But
it's
the
clear, it's
people
clear.
with heterozygous genotype would have 50% red blood cells that which are healthy and 50% which are sickled. When the malaria would attack on these people, they have more chance of survival. Why? Because the sickle cell have only 3 days to live. Two
Okay,
to three
okay,
days
sir.
to live. So the people with sickle cell anemia are more in Africa because they are better surviving the malaria than those people which have 100%, who have 100% healthy red blood cells, but they are getting killed by the malaria. So
Okay, sir.
see, sometime the disease is causing the selection of the of a feature.
Natural selection.
Yes.
Okay, ठीक है सर.
All right. So now this is basically the design of the primary immune response is basically, you can plot it on a graph, and over here you can write your maybe antibodies, and over here you can mention the time. So if it is primary immune response, then maybe suppose that the red line is representing the disease or the pathogen. So
Okay.
2 days, 4 days, 6 days, 10 days, 10, 12. So the number of pathogen would increase very steeply, at least for initial 4 days or maybe 5 days. Then meanwhile, your body would start the immune response and ultimately would start producing the antibodies. Let's say the green is representing the antibodies. So now the number of antibodies would increase. Okay, let me change the y-axis. I would just say number,
Okay.
and it is pathogen. Okay, so antibodies are now increasing because your body has learned the design of antigen, and antibodies are now increasing. Right after the increase of antibodies, there would be a fall in the number of the pathogens.
Okay, sir.
Very clear fall. So, but this is taking time. So this is the primary immune response. This is the
Okay.
primary immune response. Now, in the secondary immune response, you already
So
have
what we did
cells.
right now was primary immunity response, right? The one that we did right now. Okay,
Yes,
sir.
yes. In the secondary immune response, your pathogen now 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. I did not mention 8 over here. So the pathogen would enter and would immediately killed within 1 to 2 days, while the number of antibodies would be like
Very steep.
this.
Okay.
It would be very, there would be a very steep rise because you already have the memory cells.
Okay, sir.
Now, if you understand this thing, then you might also understand the principle of vaccination program, the first dose, second dose, and the booster dose. The first dose is to create the primary immune response.
Primary immune response. Okay, sir.
The second dose and the booster doses are for the secondary and further immune responses. What is the benefit of repeatedly exposing the antigens?
Sir, they are active. They're active. They are and alert as well.
Okay. Sorry. I forgot to mention one thing about the secondary immune response. In the secondary immune response, the pathogen is, this is suppose, this is the pathogen, and this is the antigen present. And suppose that this is the B lymphocyte. In what color I mentioned the B lymphocyte there? Green. Okay. So hold on. I have to keep the color same. So now, in secondary immune response, suppose that this is your memory cell, or B, memory B.
Okay.
It would attach to the antigen.
Macrophage.
No. This is the antigen. Now this is direct pathogen.
Okay, sir. ठीक है.
Because we now have much of the B lymphocyte, higher number of B lymphocyte that is complementary to this antigen. So now we no more need the macrophage.
Okay, sir.
Initially, we first needed the macrophage, then we needed the T lymphocyte, then we called the B lymphocyte, and then the antibodies were made.
Sir,
But
can I ask a
now,
question?
sure.
Sir, so no cytokine is produced, and no, so in the secondary response, mostly the B memory B cells are produced, right?
There is a very high chance that in secondary immune response, the memory B cell would directly expose to the antigen.
Okay. Sir, is there any signal chemical produced in this kind
No.
of response, secondary one?
Most of the time, no.
Okay.
Because right after the pathogens increase their number, there is a very high chance that one of the expanded clone would expose to that antigen. And since it is complementary, so it would attach to the antigen. Understood?
Yes, sir. Yes, it's understood.
Now the B cell, this memory B cell would now perform one thing. Now you would be surprised. This would first create more memory.
Okay.
And then it would turn into plasma cell. They would produce antibodies.
Okay.
Now imagine what would happen with each dose. With each dose, there would be a rise in memory cells. With each dose, your antigen is exposed to the B lymphocyte or maybe the T lymphocyte. And with each exposure, they would increase the memory cells. And once they would increase the memory cells, you are going better and better. Here in Pakistan, the children are exposed to the polio vaccination for 5 years. Why?
Sir, to create more memory cells.
Yes. For 5 years, your polio vaccination is provided, so you have sufficient enough memory cells for against polio, because polio is one of the most dangerous thing. It leaves the children handicapped.
Yes, sir.
So what happens that you and you also must know that polio vaccine is one of the weakest type of vaccine. You cannot every time inject the children, you know. You cannot inject a syringe every time into the children, so you use the oral vaccinations. The oral vaccinations are one of the weakest vaccinations. That is another reason that you have to expose the children for so much time.
So I always had this question that when the polio drops are given to the child, aren't they automatically digested in the stomach because of the pH?
There would have been a very high chance of this occasion, but it has been repeatedly tested, and this does not happen.
Okay.
This does not happen, but it leaves our vaccine very weak. So that is why
sir.
we have to give a repeated exposure for 5 years to build enough memory. So
okay,
the
sir.
memory cells would rise with each dose, and you would have a very high chance of getting prevented by the disease, like it occurred in the corona. They gave the booster dose, and it resulted in the herd immunity. So yes, it was very it was a very high, like it was a high time, and they quite successfully achieved their goal. So the principle of secondary immune response is basically this. You may refer it to B lymphocyte or T lymphocyte, but the principle is same.
Okay, sir. So does in the secondary response, only the B lymphocyte produces the antibodies. So can we say that is why the T lymphocytes are not needed that much in the secondary response?
No, if the T lymphocytes are exposed to the antigen first rather than B, then there would be a bit delay. Why?
Yeah.
Because now the T lymphocyte would have to call the B lymphocyte.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So there would be a bit of delay in the secondary immune response, but it would not be unsuccessful. Still, it would be a bit delayed. So it would be always beneficial that B lymphocyte would be exposed to the antigen rather than T lymphocyte in the secondary immune response.
Okay,
now one more thing I was about to tell you, the T killer cells. The T killer cells basically are those cells, they have some vesicles in them which are filled with some poison.
Okay.
Poison vesicles. So what do they do? Suppose that this is your tissue, these are your tissue cells, and these are damaged cells. So the T killer cells would approach, under the action of cytokines, they would approach the infected cell. They would fuse themselves with the infected cell, not the pathogen, the infected cell. And once they would fuse it, suppose it would look like this. And it is also drawn in your book.
Okay, sir.
This is the infected cell. This is the infected cell, and this one is the T killer. So it would release the poison into it, and it will kill it because it is infected.
Okay.
So that is why they are called as T killers. Okay, now one more very important past paper terminology, and that is the and you will also read it over here in your syllabus, and that is the cell mediated immunity and the humoral immunity.
Okay.
Cell mediated immunity is the immunity where you say that the cell themselves are directly involved.
Okay.
Themselves are directly involved. So this cell mediated immunity is performed by the T cells, T lymphocytes. If you remember, the T lymphocytes are directly involved whether it is the T helper or T killer. But what is humoral immunity? In humoral immunity, you can say it is also called as fluid immunity. What does it mean? The cells don't move much. Instead, they would release antibodies into blood. Antibodies which would float in the blood and reach the antigen.
Okay, sir.
So that is why it is called as humoral immunity, fluid immunity.
Both of them are done by the lymphocytes.
Yes, both of them are. This is a similarity between them. Both of them are done by the lymphocytes.
Not the
but
phagocytes.
One, no, not by the phagocytes.
Yes, sir. Okay, clear.
So that is okay, all right. So what do you know about the active and passive immunity?
So I wanted to ask you about this.
Okay, so active immunity and passive immunity. Now, the thing is, the active immunity, in the word active immunity, remember that the word active basically refers to the involvement of the body. It basically means that body is showing immune response. Showing immune response. So, in active immunity, basically you can say the body is exposed to antigen. Antigen. The macrophages appear. Macrophages appear. Then the lymphocytes, like you can say plasma cells are made. Plasma cells are made. Antibodies are made.
Okay, understood.
All the immune response things.
Okay, sir.
So when the body is actively showing immune response, that would be called as active immunity.
Okay, sir.
It can happen in two ways. One is natural active. In natural active, you literally expose to pathogen and you get sick.
By the vaccination process.
No. That is the vaccination is artificial active. And in this, you are exposed to antigen mostly, not the pathogen. Most of the time in vaccination, in artificial active, you are exposed to antigen, which basically are treated. You can say dead pathogens or weakened pathogens, or maybe a piece of antigen is directly entered into your body. So that is
So
basically artificial.
to lower
Sorry, repeat.
the threat of the pathogen.
Exactly.
Okay.
To lower the threat, to increase the memory cells.
Okay, sir.
And one more thing about the active immunity, that in this memory is made.
Okay,
So
memory
in
is
both
made.
type, the memory would be made. The second is passive. Okay, in passive, body is not showing any immune response. Immune response. Body is not showing immune response. And you can simply say, the infected body or the patient
Yes,
or the
sir.
patient is provided with already made antibodies directly injected into the blood.
So can we say
Body
medicine?
does not show. No. This is not medicine. Now, there is a huge difference between this and medicine. The medicine is not working on the principle of antibody. The medicine just it is either directly killing the pathogen or maybe it is relieving you of something. The antibodies are purely protein made, and they would always work on the principle of antibody.
Okay,
So
sir.
you cannot say it is medicine. It is sometime the okay, let me clarify one thing, then I'll give you answer a bit more of your answer. The solution of antibodies that has been provided, the solution of antibodies is called as anti-serum.
Okay.
It is not vaccine. It is not medicine. Okay,
Okay.
let me give you a very, very typical idea. If something is vaccination or vaccine, it would be containing antigen in it. But if something is anti-serum, it would be containing antibodies in it.
Okay, sir.
And your body is basically provided with already made antibodies so that now what happens that in some diseases you cannot wait for the body.
Okay,
in
sir,
some diseases you cannot wait for the body's response. Why? Because they are deadly. Suppose rabies. In rabies you cannot wait.
Yes, sir.
You directly inject anti-serum into the wound, you know?
Yes, sir. Yes.
In snake venom, you cannot wait. So that is why you have passive immunity.
Sir, how long does an immune system, like an active immunity, take?
If it is a primary immune response, it can take 5 to 15 days.
Okay. Just like you showed in the graph, I remember. Okay.
Yes, 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 yes. Okay, then the passive immunity is also natural and artificial. Okay, the question is how the passive immunity can be natural. Like obviously, the natural and providing the antibodies, it is through mother's milk.
Okay, sir.
When the baby gets sick, the mother provides. And artificial passive is the same thing as the anti-serum.
Okay.
We provide the body with anti-sera, so that anti-sera is a plural. So so that you get like you may have heard that there are multiple injections that are inoculated into the body of a person who has been bit by the by a rabid dog. So that is because we need to increase the number of antibodies as much as we can, because rabies is just a death certificate. Simply, there is no cure.
It spreads really fast, right? It depends on
how.
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Okay. So, all right. So these are the diagrams. I have been already making these diagrams on the Jamboard. So you can, this is a plasma cell, and you can see one thing very clearly in it. That is obviously this thing is
RER.
These are the RER. What are these small lines?
Wait.
What are these small spiral thingies?
So these are the RERs, right?
Yes. Sorry. You were saying this already, right?
Yes. So I thought maybe
Yeah, no. I think I did not get your voice clearly.
Okay, no worries.
Alright, okay. So do you know about the structure of antibody?
No, sir. Oh yeah, antibody. I know it is made up of four polypeptides, and two of them are heavy chains and two are the light chains, two genes. This is what you're saying, right?
Yes. Okay. These chains of sugar molecules, they basically act as antigens of antibodies.
Okay.
If an antibody is coming from outside source, there is a very high chance, and especially if you are taking the antibody from an animal source, there is a very high chance that your body would react against it based on the position of sugar molecule chain. So that basically is the thing about these sugar molecules. Why am I telling you this? Because there is a very important topic coming ahead, hybridoma, in which we use this concept that we can. Are you familiar with this topic, hybridoma, or no?
No, sir, I'm not.
Sorry
Okay. to disappoint you.
No problem, no problem. Vaccination programs. Oh, sorry, it's in the same chapter. It's not in that. Okay. Obviously, the number of cases are reducing, immunization. Official coverage is this. UNICEF estimates WHO. Okay, fine. Monoclonal antibodies and hybridomas, uses of them. Okay. So what do you suggest that if we arrange a time 15 to 25 minutes tomorrow to do the monoclonal antibodies and hybridomas?
Okay, sir.